Welcome to the cabin. It's a place of rest, relaxation, and peace. Have a seat at the table and enjoy Kim Aspen's music from the vintage radio. The cocoa is for you, and there's fresh bread if you'd like some. There's also a slice of apple on the plate. You can smell the scent of pine from the Christmas tree. Stay as long as you'd like. It's cold outside and it's starting to snow, but the cabin is warm and cozy. You can notice out the windows the animals of the forest. There are deer, rabbits, squirrel, maybe even an owl. If you close your eyes and press the B button on the left controller, when you open them, you'll be in the kitchen, looking out that way. You can smell the scent of cookies baking in the oven. As you notice that you're breathing a little slower, it's so peaceful here. Safe, warm, and comfortable. You're starting to relax from the top of your head down to the bottom of your feet. And you feel your shoulders loosen as your arms and legs become heavy. Sit as long as you'd like. Or lay down and take a little nap and press the B button again. The glow from the lantern is soft, and there are presents under the tree. There will be more tonight after Santa comes. Enjoy the night before Christmas. 'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from the bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint Nick. More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came. And he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen. O Comet, on Cupid, Donner and Blixen. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, Down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys was flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up in a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk. And laying his fingers aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprung to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night."